Before I pronounce you husband and wife, Kelsey, I told you earlier, how could I possibly quantify my love for you, what you mean to me? Words would only lessen how I feel. They would be futile. So I thought maybe a song would help. There's one thing I know for sure. She was sent here from heaven, and she's daddy's little girl. I dropped to my knees by her bed each night. She talks to Jesus, and I close my eyes and I thank God. You know, folks, when your world caves in and it turns upside down, you have to find your true north again. You have to focus on what is true because you don't know what to think. And so the 23rd Psalm helped save my life. That's why I have the first line tattooed on my forearm. As you go this day, always remember, the Lord is your shepherd. You shall not be in want of any good thing.
You will lie down in green pastures. You will lie beside quiet waters. He will restore your soul. He will guide you in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And sometimes, even though those paths may lead you through the valley of the shadow of death, you don't have to be afraid. For he is with you. His rod and his staff will comfort you. He will set a table before you in the presence of your enemies. He will anoint your head with oil. Your cup will overflow. Surely, goodness and mercy will follow you all the days of your life. And we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Well, my friends, ladies and gentlemen, family, we have worshiped together, we've laughed together, we've cried together, we've celebrated for this moment. And so, with the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel, it is my joy to pronounce you husband and wife. Brandon, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great joy that I have the privilege of introducing to you for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Brandon Ritz.
Yes,
please stay as our guests for our banquet in just a little while.